Todd, it would not be biotech if it weren't for the pipeline blowups and setbacks that always seem to happen. 2018 was no exception to that, but there were some notable pipeline blowups this year.
We could have done an entire show on swings and misses, right, Shannon? I mean, unfortunately, it's just the nature of the beast in biotech. It's notorious for its failed trials. Like 90% of clinical trials end up failing to pan out. So it's not shocking that there were a number of setbacks. One that might have been a little shocking, we've talked about on the show before, is Celgene's refused to file letter that it got in February from the FDA for its arguably most important pipeline drug, ozanimod, which is a drug that is to be used in multiple sclerosis as an oral drug that would compete against Galenia, which is a $3 billion plus drug. Celgene went out and paid $7 billion to land that drug. And everybody was looking forward to that one getting filed early this year, and then getting approved before the end of this year. Didn't happen. You know, unfortunately, the FDA looked at the application and said, no, we can't review this. You're going to have to get together more information and resubmit it to us.
And I think that is truly one of the more embarrassing stories of 2018. And this is Celgene. This is one of the big biotechs that every little biotech hopes to become one day. And so to have that management misstep to where there's not even enough evidence for the FDA to review to say that this drug is approvable is, you know, unquestionably disappointing. I am encouraged, though, with Celgene. I know they've had some management shuffles throughout the year, so I think they're getting back on track. But certainly that was one that just had a lot of people scratching their heads. The next one we talked a little bit about, but of course that was Incyte and their phase 3 flop as well.
Yeah, the IDO inhibitor being used with PD-1, that came up short in April, and obviously that caused a big sell-off in Incyte shares, and it caused IDO programs at various different companies to get shuttered. That was a devastating blow. But even more devastating than Incyte's failure was probably the news that J&J wasn't going to continue, or that it was abandoning development of Geron's imetelstat, a drug for or therapy for myelofibrosis, myelodysplastic syndromes.
Yeah, and I know we've talked about this at length with Geron. This has been one of the more polarizing biotech stocks to watch. And I think you definitely saw the red flags have been there leading up to this breakup with J&J. But ultimately, what you have now is Geron just kind of holding on, hoping maybe a partner might come in. But really, their cash is dwindling. I think this will be a stock that I'd say if I had to rank the ones that I don't think will make it, this would probably be near the top of that list.
And 2019 will be key, right? Because they could theoretically suffer a cash crunch by the end of next year. So it'll be very interesting to see what they do with this drug. If J&J had gone forward and taken this drug into phase 3, it would have been a huge payday. It would have been a very different story for investors in Geron. You know, Geron's shares lost 62% of their value when J&J walked away. And I looked early this morning, only trading at $1.40 a share. That's down from $6 prior to the decision back in September. Obviously, a big bummer for those shareholders. The list goes on and on, though, Shannon, right? I mean, you hinted at the top of the show, Synergy Pharmaceuticals probably making that list even longer this year. This morning, announcing that they're actually going to go and declare bankruptcy in order to sell their assets off to Bausch and Lomb for about $200 million. Synergy obviously had launched a constipation drug to battle against Linzess, the top seller in the indication. However, they just had too much debt in the books. They weren't able to refinance that debt. And, you know, with sales just not ramping up nearly as quickly as was necessary, now they've had to basically shut down their operations and fire sale the rest of their assets.
Yeah, so I'm sure there'll be many more to come in 2019.